Throughout history, law has been an important driver for civil rights, for the environment.
We look at using the courts to right wrongs that exist in society.
From a standpoint of a local government like the city of Santa Cruz, the legal system is probably the most effective tool to deal with the impacts of climate change.
There are a few really interesting cases that are happening right now. Young people bringing cases both in the United States but also elsewhere.
India has a lot of policies on the issue of climate change. But on ground, these policies are not translating into effective measures.
If the government is not doing anything, then only recourse is to go to the courts. The first question from the judge was, why a child?
Children are the biggest stakeholders when it comes to climate change issues. And they're not part of the decision-making process.
You have young people suing the government because the government is not acting on climate and that's threatening their lives and the lives of future generations.
What, there's one child in the NPA case, but there's how many?
21 on the federal case in the United States.
Yeah. And then on the other side, you have cities and counties in California who are suing energy companies.
In this case, the city is suing 29 major carbon-producing industries.
The oil companies have known for decades of what they were doing and the impact that they were creating.
They even invested in raising their oil rigs and took other measures to protect themselves.
They lied about it, they blocked legislation, and we're going to seek justice in the courts.
They have responsibility to our community and our taxpayers to help pay for the impacts that we're seeing with climate change. It's happening fast. And it's real for the people who live here.
They're saying, well, you knew, and you went ahead and did it anyways, and more than that, you actively did not tell anyone. And now the counties and the taxpayers and the citizens, you and I, are paying that cost, and that's not fair.